Hello all, welcome to my next video. This time I'm actually in the Discovery. I'm going to talk a little bit about the Discovery, things I like, things I don't like, kind of how it drives, and also of course ramble on a little bit about some other cars, some other things. So let's get into it. So a little bit about my Discovery. This is a 2017 Discovery HSE Luxury. It is finished in the gorgeous Aintree Green, also known as British Racing Green, with the vintage tan premium Windsor leather interior, with the charcoal gray gloss oak wood veneer. Also looks excellent with this. This has been a great car for us. We've had it almost 4 years in almost 30,000 miles. I have about 40 miles to go until I hit 30,000. Hasn't had a single mechanical issue. It's been great and it drives really well. It suspension tuning I think is great. Engine's great. Technology, this in-control touch pro infotainment system is not the best, but it works. It's got a wonderful 825 watt 15 speaker Meridian surround sound system with three different surround modes. So first off you have stereo, which is no surround, and then you have Dolby Pro Logic 2 DTS Neo 6 and the pièce de résistance, the Meridian tri-field surround sound, which is amazing. It blends the center and side channels, so you are completely, like, surrounded in sound, no pun intended. And it's awesome. Like, if you buy a JLR product with the Meridian surround sound, leave it in the Meridian tri-field. Don't listen to anything else. It's honestly amazing. It's one of the best audio systems I've heard in a car. It's extremely clear. You know, bass response is excellent. Mids and highs are crystal clear. It really is amazing. Oh no, is that what I think it is? Is that an I-Pace? No, it is. Wow, you know, that's like maybe the third I-Pace I've seen, like, on the road without dealer plates. That's interesting. You don't see a lot of those. I've yet to drive one. I've been told they are very good. Is it as good as Mach-E? I don't know. I feel like it's not going to be as performance-oriented as Mach-E, but obviously the interior... I mean, I've been in I-Paces at the dealership, and I've, you know, the interior is much nicer than Mach-E. And knowing Jaguar, I mean, they make really good driving cars. I've always said the XE was, like, the best compact luxury sedan to drive. I hope you can see me. It's currently, what time is it? 20 to 7. It's dark, it's raining. I have the dome light on. Hopefully that helps. If not, I do apologize. Also, an interesting thing that happened. This is the third or fourth time this has happened. Yesterday, I was at the store. I had to pick up some bread. And I was getting back into my car. And this very attractive girl, probably about 5 years older than me, or I'd say, complimented my Defender. And she said, "Oh, I love your Jeep." This has happened before, and, well, someone told me, you know who you are, really the only thing you can do is give him a throat punch, although that is highly illegal. I can't do that. I wouldn't do that anyway, but... This is the sound of 340 very angry British horses tell you what, the ZF 8-speed automatic transmission in this, I feel like, is tuned a little bit more toward performance than in my Defender. It shifts noticeably quicker, but at the same time, it's still very much oriented for an SUV or off-roader. But that's just something I thought I should point out. Yeah, ZF 8-speed has always been the best automatic torque converter, automatic transmission. Ask anyone. It's not invasive. It's extremely smooth. You don't feel it shift. Shifts are incredibly quick. It's just a great transmission. You know, it's not Porsche's PDK, which is a silly name. Porsche Doppelkupplungsgetriebe. She's German for Porsche double clutch. That's a great gearbox. I mean, it PDK is so quick, so smooth. Just everything about it is wonderful. So right now I am passing Kings Island Amusement Park in Mason, Ohio. Mason is a suburb of Cincinnati where I live. It's about 20 miles north of Cincinnati. Kings Island is one of the largest theme parks in the country. People come from actually all over the world to ride the roller coasters and stuff here. Most recent addition is a roller coaster called Orion, which is one of only a handful of giga roller coasters in the world. It was a big deal that we got one here. Of course, I haven't been here in years. I used to go all the time when I was a young lad. But yeah, we also have a replica of the Eiffel Tower. So I have no reason to go to Paris. I can just, you know, drive 8 minutes from my house and see a smaller version of the Eiffel Tower. A lot of traffic on this road this morning, which is surprising. I'm on like a back road here. Well, it's not really a back road, but... ooh, a Hummer H2. That is a vulgar car, but very interesting. I love those when I was a kid. This is an extreme hairpin turn. Whoa, okay. Right now I'm passing the Peters Cartridge Factory, which is an old gunpowder factory. You know, it's now turned into industrial-style apartments, as well as a brewery, a microbrewery. Of course, Cincinnati is the home of the microbrewery. But, yeah, that's a place that it was abandoned for years. And, you know, juvenile teenagers like me, a few years ago, would go there and, you know, there was always a police officer or security guard that would run people down. People would go there and, like, you know, like, go ghost hunting and shit. And, you know, I never saw anything, but it was more for the thrill factor. I never ran into a security guard there. I went there once, like, I don't know, like 11:30 at night. I'll tell you what, the Kings Island parking lot is massive. It's gotta be, I don't know how long it is, probably, man, a mile? And that would be awesome to like set up an autocross course there or do like drag racing, because it is wide open, can't hit anything. Of course, it's not very flat, but you know, that would be like a wicked place for like an autocross course. And if we get
body, yes, I crank it every day. Haters get mad cause I got me so bad tonight. Y'all the boy, I've been it. Why me crank it, why me roll? Why me?
You know they're all the same. You know you're doing better on your own. So don't buy in.
Oh, god damn it. Who's texting me? A few things, like I said, about Discovery, like I said, HSE luxury, so it is top trim level. It, so again, like I kind of already went over my spec, entry green, exterior, vintage tan interior with the charcoal oak veneer, the gloss charcoal oak veneer, also the black headliner, which is really nice. It also has the remote intelligent seat fold package. So what that does is you can fold any of the second, third row seats on the touchscreen or via the Land Rover remote app on your phone. And I remember when they revealed this car, shortly before they did, they had Bear Grylls and his friends. They went skydiving and there was a Discovery on the ground waiting for them. And Bear Grylls had an iPad attached to his wrist, and he was using the app to fold up all the seats so his friends could get in while he was skydiving. So by the time they got down, you know, they were all ready to go. Which is, that was pretty cool. It's kind of a gimmick, really kind of unnecessary, but at the same time, I feel like there is a use for that. It is a family vehicle. Like, you know, let's say if you're, you know, somewhere and you need to pick up a lot of people and you forget to fold the seats, you know, you can just pull out your phone and, you know, by the time you get back to the car, your seats are up. Or if you're like at the store and you bought a bunch of stuff and there's not enough room in the back, well, same thing. You just pull out your phone, fold down the seats, and by the time you need to, you know, put all the cargo in, it's ready. You know, another thing, there's a lot of really clever storage features in this car. So obviously there is the dual glove box, which is really nice. Land Rover is known for that. There's also a button on the center console where the climate controls are. It says open. Once you press it, the whole panel folds down, and that's where your CD player is. And there's also like hidden storage in there. You can slide the cup holders all the way back, and there's a ton of storage in there. I think you can fit like an iPad in there. Center console is huge. This one does not have the refrigerator. It's really deep. You can fit a lot of stuff in there. Yeah, there's all sorts of like just clever storage features. There's tons of USB ports. This one has, I believe, 7, so there is one USB port for every passenger. Other features it has, so heated everything, heated first and second row seats, heated steering wheel, heated front windshield, heated washer jets. It does not have cooled seats or massaging seats. That was part of like the luxury climate package, which this one was not fitted with. And that, so the luxury climate package, if I'm not mistaken, that included heated and cooled first and second row seats, heated third row, and front massaging seats. Uh-oh, rear left tire pressure low. I'll have to check that out once I get home. Just had new tires put on the other day as well. That will be it for today's video. Thank you so much for tuning in. Be sure to, you know, like, subscribe, hit the bell icon, every, you know, YouTube thing. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.